So, okay, I want to make it clear, okay, and I want to make it clear in the show we do, Runorder, when we do it later. This AB de Villiers coming out of retirement, I mean, how entitled can that be? You can't do that. Once you retire, you retire. He's a great cricketer. I love AB de Villiers, but he's retired. It's his word, a man's word is his bond. You've said you're retired, you're gone, in my book. That's it. I can't believe these guys.
But didn't you come out of retirement from television 6 months ago?
See, it's not the same thing. And I'll explain why. Because I was more injured than, you know, per se, retired. Retired is not the right phrase. I was injured, my back was paining, and I didn't want to stand up and perform. So that was a different... you know, I mean, it's not... It's apples and oranges. Apples and oranges. Okay, we're back here on Runorder. Exciting time for all of us with a brand new set. But same people on the couch. But brand new set, because all four people who watched the show wrote in separately, different letterheads, and said, give us something special. So here it is.
But you don't have a chair.
I don't have a chair because I'm a dancer. I'm nifty, nifty with my feet. And I'll do this for the rest of the show if we don't start with a topic.
I will. I'd love to. What a terrible start for South Africa, Cyrus, to the World Cup.
0-3? Not so bad.
Not so bad. This time they're not even building the expectations and then destroying them. But what's more sensational is what's happened just in the aftermath of the India defeat and news coming in that AB de Villiers had a shocking, sensational potential return to this team. And it was the selection panel that said no. Selectors have decided they're going to go on principle. There are guys that have worked to try and replace that big vacuum that de Villiers had left. And they're just going to go with whoever else. They're not going to pick de Villiers.
See, we don't understand it from an Indian context because Indians don't retire. So I don't think we can
do
it.
Yeah.
I mean,
I think Tendulkar should open next game.
Stop it.
Okay. What I can say is that, I mean, you would think that the AB de Villiers and what he's achieved for South African cricket, that he would want to be a part of this World Cup.
Yes.
I mean, knowing that it might be his last World Cup and he would want to have an impression. Now to make an entire 180 degree turn and to come back and say that you'll make yourself available, I think that's not being fair to Cricket South Africa and to the players who've trained and prepared for this World Cup.
So it's wrong. They shouldn't get AB de Villiers in.
Yeah, I think it's the right decision
the
to
logic,
deny the opportunity to have
the pure
it.
Cricket logic of a batsman who's still good enough perhaps to, I think, good enough to be the top batsman still.
Well, the one thing we shouldn't forget, it's a team sport. It's not an individual sport. I mean, it doesn't matter how great you've been. It's an unnecessary distraction for a team who's already struggling. Anyone would like AB de Villiers in their team. I mean, I think from what we see from the statement from Cricket South Africa, you've seen that they gave him the option of actually playing less cricket, but you've got to play some cricket with the team.
Let's just look at it right now. He wants to come back. Why would they say no?
But how do you think he's still good enough for international cricket? Doesn't matter how great he's been. No, I mean, I don't think there's a question about his ability to play. Sometimes it's a principle. You've got to adhere to some principles within the team.
You guys, both the experts are saying that it's not done. He can't just walk into the team, no matter how talented
Not
he
on
is.
The eve of the World Cup or your selection for the World Cup.
See, we are talking in hindsight. What if ABD had been selected? He had three ducks in the first three games. Then all of them would have criticized the selectors saying
or
that...
Or South Africa had won the three games.
Either way, sir, they would have said that you can't bring somebody who, like Ajit said,
no, but they
absolutely
won the three
no
games.
Cricket. No, if he's got out for three ducks and assume the situation is the same, everybody would have blamed the selector saying he had no international cricket. IPL is not same as international. We saw that with Kevin Peterson for England, though it was not a similar case. There was other issues and he didn't fit in the culture of the team. Other big issue is a lot of South African players are already going because of Kolpak. So by doing something like this, what you're setting an example that look, we don't, some youngster, say Rassi, the guy who's actually replaced ABD, he might say, look, this is what's happened to me, I'd rather go and play, go the Kolpak route.
Also, it's not that the World Cup is, you know, last minute sort of a tournament that's been announced. He very well knew that it was going to come. He took that decision. Also, I mean, you know, he at that time had said he's done with cricket, he's done with international cricket. So I'm just a bit surprised at what's really changed from there to just 24 hours before the World Cup.
Moving away from de Villiers and back to South Africa, because I believe that's the issue that we're looking at right now. I'm getting calls from the South African embassy. Help us.
I'm glad that somewhere South Africa is so playing so poorly that it will help them sort of rebuild their structure, look into how their cricket is, how their pipeline is, has dried up. How the Kolpak deals are taking away a lot of good players.
A good point Malay makes is that South Africa is suddenly going, it's a conversation we were almost having of Australia a little while back. Where are the reserves? Where's the depth? Dale Steyn gets injured. You can't expect Dale Steyn to carry a World Cup at this age. And one fast bowler, Lungi Ngiri, gets injured and suddenly they're all over the place. After this World Cup, Faf du Plessis may not play. Hashim Amla may not play another World Cup. Which leaves you with what? Just Aidan Markram and Quinton de Kock? There's not much
JP
promise.
JP Duminy might have trouble
Miller
getting back.
Miller and Duminy are an issue.
What will happen? There's six games to play. Can they still come back? Is it possible?
I can't see them making the semi-finals. I don't think they've played as well as they can. They've got the team. I don't think they're as bad a team as what their performances are.
Biggest challenge for them will be the off-the-field pressure. The pressure from their supporters, public. From all
from
the
Malay,
things.
Who wants
AB
to
de Villiers wanting to come back, the injuries. How they mask themselves from all these off-the-field issues will determine their destiny.
But the biggest shocker has been their fielding. I mean, it's just so un-South African that you've seen in this World Cup.
But will they come back?
I doubt it. I'm looking at the matches that they're playing. They'll get a few wins, but I don't think they'll need to win about five out of the
five
six.
They have to win minimum,
yeah, but
five
in
home.
I doubt that.
South Africa have lost to the two top teams. They have lost one game to Bangladesh. That if they had beaten that, we wouldn't be having this discussion, because you expect most teams to lose to India and England this World Cup. So basically, South Africa is battling for the fourth spot. If they get a win against New Zealand, because Bangladesh lost to New Zealand, so if South Africa beat New Zealand, it all becomes a much more
rosy
the
optimist
picture.
In you and also the cousins that you have.
So my point is, it's hard, yeah. But it's not impossible.
Okay,
no,
so
it's not
one
impossible,
optimist.
But unfortunately, they're not playing well.
Absolutely.
That's the problem.
Yeah. And also, I suppose, as we wrap it up here, if you let de Villiers come in, where do you draw the line? Alan Donald will want to come back, you know. I mean, Sean Pollock, Graham Pollock, I mean, there's no end to it. So that's it. That's all we have time for. My classical South African drive as played by the one and only Faf du Plessis. Oh, damn.
Don't forget to like, share, subscribe and leave your comments in the comment section below. Click on the bell icon for notifications.